From the 1400s to the 1500s, a magnificent empire in Mexico was ruled by an American Indian tribe now known as the Aztecs. This tribe was one of the most advanced civilizations in the Americas and had built cities and temples as large as any in Europe or Asia at that time. The Aztecs improved a lot of things before the time to understand things was even possible. In this video, we will discover how the Aztec influenced the world as we know today through their creation of paintings, writings, and numbers.
Though painting was a very important part of the Aztec culture, they didn't tend to paint much outside of making pictographs. Aztec art was centered around pottery and metallurgy. This isn't to say that they didn't paint at all, but their paintings were for practical reasons. Common subjects in Aztec paintings were the gods, warfare, and political figures. Some pictorial conventions include depicting individuals of wealth or power in very vibrant colors, and depicting gods in the form of animals that were related to their powers and nature. Outside of pictographs, paintings were also used as tribute to the gods. A lot of the paintings were commissioned by priests and the ruling class and painted on codices and on the walls of temples and palaces. Coral, chalk, clay, and stone were commonly used in paintings and drawings. Works of art were often decorated with pieces of stones and metals such as gold, silver, and copper. Despite the absence of a potter's wheel, the Aztecs are known for their intricate ceramics. There is not an abundance of ancient Aztec pottery due to a tradition of breaking all their household goods at the end of each 52-year cycle. Aztecs were also particularly skilled in metallurgy. In the word of German artist Albrecht Dürer, "I have never in all my days seen that which rejoiced my heart as these things. For I saw among them amazing artistic objects, and I marveled over the subtle ingenuity of men in distant lands." Despite their talent for it, the ability to work metal did not originate in Mexico where the Aztecs lived, but is believed to have first been introduced in Central or South America. Metals were commonly worked and melted with very high temperatures, which were often created by metalworkers blowing air through the blowpipes into a furnace, a method that also has some prevalence in the mochi art of Peru. To make jewelry, the metal was hammered into sheets by repeatedly striking a flat hammer stone on a large stone anvil. Another technique that was prevalent in Aztec metallurgy was the lost wax technique, in which a mold was made from a wax and then covered with clay, then fired, melting the wax inside and leaving a hollow mold to be filled with molten metal. Most artifacts made of gold and silver were melted by the Spanish to make currency, but some smaller items, such as pieces of jewelry, remain. The pottery and stone sculptures of the Aztecs have better stood up to time and conquest. One important example of Aztec stonework is the sunstone. Carved from basalt, it is massive, weighing 25 tons with a diameter just under 12 feet and a thickness more than 3. It depicts 5 consecutive worlds of the sun, which was the way the Aztecs divided history into eras. From the sunstone's great size and intricacy, we can see the great skill of the Aztecs in their stonework. As we have seen, this same skill is present in the other forms of Aztec art. Additionally, the sunstone is an example of the religious themes prevalent in Aztec art. All of this is to say that all types of Aztec art share common traits that reflect the values of their society.
Now let's move on to Aztec writing. Aztec society was rich in arts, literature, and culture that flourished over several centuries even after the conquest of the empire by the Spaniards. However, before the advent of the Spaniards, the Aztec language did not have a system of written script, meaning it did not have a fully developed system of writing since it lacked alphabets, and instead, messages were conveyed through pictographs and various drawings. Aztec writings consisted of and functioned as calendar dates, to record mathematical equations, to write down the vigesimal number system. One of the most evident calendar cycles recorded was the 260-day Tonopah that was written in a language called Nahuatl. Just like various elements of Aztec art and culture, Aztec writing was also heavily influenced by the previous Mesoamerican cultures. It was an adapted form of the previous writing systems that existed in central Mexico. In particular, the Zapotec writings, whose influence can be seen in the first Oaxacan inscriptions. The Aztec, however, developed the technique of pictograms and wrote a variety of codices to transfer oral knowledge. Much of Aztec writings were drawings and symbols, each symbol depicting a word. Certain combinations of symbols or pictures would represent name of towns. These symbols can be thought of as ideograms in which the objects express their own natures, but also the underlying ideas and not concepts associated with them. Thus, the idea of death can be represented by a corpse wrapped for burial, night by a black sky, and a closed eye wore by a shield and a club, or speech by a little scroll issuing from the mouth of the person who's talking. Concepts involving the idea of motion, walking, migration, or the sequence of events were usually indicated by a trail of footprints going in the necessary direction. The pictographic system was central to the Aztec writing, and this was the main way of transferring knowledge and information in the Aztec society. Since the Aztec writing did not exist in the form of modern writing containing alphabets, education in Aztec schools was given from the codices containing pictograms. These drawings were used to disseminate information and knowledge which was passed in the oral and pictographic form from previous generation to the next ones. Aztec writing did not have a fully developed writing system due to the lack of alphabets. But sure, they made rich use of pictograms and logograms to transmit information and knowledge down the generations. Aztec pictograms and logograms are preserved in a variety of codices. Additionally, Aztec has their own number system using 20 as its base, which was used for the calculation of tax and tribute. And speaking of numbers, finally, we are going to talk about the Aztec number system. In terms of expressing numbers, the Aztecs used Bay's 20 number system. It is called a vigesimal number system. A single dot represented by the number 1. Occasionally, a finger was also used to indicate the number. Following in this sequence, the numbers 2, 3, and 4 were represented by 2, 3, and 4 dots, respectively. 5, though, introduced a new symbol. It was represented by 5 dots or a full bar, as seen in the accompanying figure. From 6 through 9, dots alone or a combination of dots and a bar represented numbers. 10 was represented by a rhombus, 2 bars or 10 dots. The numbers between 10 and 20 were expressed as a combination of a rhombus, bars, and dots. 20 required a new symbol and resembled a flag, a shell or a vase with grass growing out of it. After 20, higher numbers were expressed as combinations of the symbols already mentioned. The numbers for 100, 200, and 300 were expressed not only with the mentioned symbols, but also by a feather with barbs, each representing 20 units. 100 had 5 barbs on the feather, 200 had 10, and 300 had 15. The next change in symbol occurred at the number 400, which was sometimes represented by 20 barbs on the feather, or by a bundle of stems tied together. For the number 8000, it was written as a symbol that represented a bag. There are 4 ways to express 8375 using Aztec symbols. We can express 8375 using a bag, 1 feather, 3 flags, and 15 dots. Instead of 15 dots, we can also use a rhombus and 5 dots, or a rhombus and a bar. Moreover, we can change the order, so we can put a bar first. The idea that the Aztec system was vigesimal stems from the fact that new symbols were produced for every power of 20. This reasoning, though, is not completely satisfactory because the symbols are for higher powers, for example, 204, 205, are unknown. As we can see from their ingenuity in writing, art, and numbers, the Aztec were a sophisticated society, not behind countries as Europe and Asia at the time.